Hello everyone, welcome to Mocking Sapien. My name is Tanay and today I'm going to talk about the economic package, 20 lakh crores. I should get a Nobel Prize after this. So in the comments say that Tanay Dhumal for Nobel Prize. Just joking, eh? नहीं तो लोग शुरू हो जाएंगे कि एक बार क्या थोड़ा स्टेटिस्टिक्स पढ़ लिया कि खुद को अभिजीत बैनर्जी समझने लगा. सो इट वॉज अ जोक. दिस इकोनॉमिक पैकेज वॉज लाइक दैट समोसा. वो आलू का समोसा होता है पर जब हम उसे खाते हैं तो वो निकलता है मटर का समोसा. इट्स डिस्गस्टिंग. तो मटर के समोसे के बारे में थोड़ी देर बाद में बात करेंगे. तो अभी जाते हैं लोकल पे वोकल.
अपने लोकल के लिए वोकल बनना है
भक्त लोगों. अभी लोकल ट्रेन के लिए चिल्लाना मत. वो लोकल प्रोडक्ट्स खरीदने की बात कर रहे हैं, लोकल ट्रेन के बारे में बात नहीं कर रहे, समझ लो प्लीज भक्तो. वो तरीका होता है एक बोलने का, नहीं तो तुम जाओगे लोकल पे चढ़ जाओगे उधर चिल्लाने. वैसे नहीं होता है. लोकल पे वोकल मतलब लोकल प्रोडक्ट्स खरीदो. देखो भाई, कमेंट्स में तो इतनी गालियां देते हो, थोड़ा हमसे भी टॉन्ट सुन लो. क्या जाता है, थोड़ा सा हम सहेंगे थोड़ा तुम सह लो. नाउ लोकल के लिए वोकल वॉज समथिंग लाइक मेक इन इंडिया. बट मेक इन इंडिया वॉज अ गुड इनिशिएटिव, नो डाउट. बट अल्टीमेटली इट वॉज अ फ्लॉप. इन 2014 द शेयर ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इन इंडियाज ग्रॉस डोमेस्टिक प्रोडक्ट GDP वॉज 15%. लास्ट ईयर इट फेल टू 14%. सो इन 5 years इट हैज रिड्यूस्ड बाय 1% रादर देन इंक्रीजिंग. सो यू शुडंट हैव अ लॉट ऑफ एक्सपेक्टेशंस फ्रॉम दिस लोकल पे वोकल. इट्स अ गुड इनिशिएटिव बट डोंट हैव अ लॉट ऑफ एक्सपेक्टेशंस फ्रॉम इट.
20 लाख करोड़ रुपए का है ये पैकेज. भारत की GDP का करीब करीब 10% है.
लाइफ वुड बी सो इजी इफ यू डिवाइडेड 20 लाख करोड़ विथ 135 crores एंड everyone got 14,000-15,000 इन their अकाउंट. इट वुड बी सो मच easier. Now, US has announced 225 lakh crore package. And this package is not liquidity measures. These are direct benefits to the people. There are two types of benefits. One through loans from the banks to the people. One is direct transfer of money to the beneficiaries. It has 5 or 5.3 trillion allocated for the COVID-19 stimulus. But out of that, 3 trillion, which is 225 lakh crores, डायरेक्ट बेनिफिशियरीज, लोगों को डायरेक्ट ट्रांसफर होगा. पीपल इन USA आर गेटिंग अराउंड $1,200 एंड फॉर चिल्ड्रन एडिशनल $500, फ्री लंच, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर देयर. सो दीज पीपल आर गिविंग इट डायरेक्टली टू द पीपल. जापान इज गिविंग $930 पर पर्सन एज कैश हैंड आउट. जर्मनी इज गिविंग 80% ऑफ देयर वेजेस हु आर रिस्किंग अ जॉब लॉस अराउंड 5,000 euros फॉर फ्री लांसर्स एंड स्मॉल बिजनेस ओनर्स फॉर देयर सर्वाइवल. फ्री लांसर्स एंड ऑल तो इन इंडिया वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट, बट एटलीस्ट फॉर द पुअर वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट. नाउ इट्स नॉट लाइक वी हैवन डन एनीथिंग एट ऑल. सो जस्ट फॉरगेट अबाउट द पीपल हु डोंट हैव बैंक अकाउंट्स, हु डोंट हैव राशन कार्ड्स, डिवोर्स एंड ऑल दीज इशूज विच आर देयर. लेट्स कंसिडर अ परफेक्ट सिचुएशन वेर एवरी वन हैज बैंक अकाउंट्स एंड ऑल दीज. वी हैव डन समथिंग फॉर द पुअर एंड समथिंग इज बेटर देन nothing. So let's see what the government has done. 1500 rupees in 20 crore women's jandhan accounts in 3 installments, 1000 rupees to senior citizens in 2 installments, 2000 rupees of 7.47 crore farmers out of 8 crores, which I will talk about a little later in the video. This may be thoda sa issue hai. Insurance cover up to 50 lakhs to 22.12 lakh workers. Free gas cylinders. 5 kilos of rice free for 80 crore people per month, 1 kilo dal per family for 3 months and some other schemes. And then 3,100 crores has been allocated from PM CARES for various things like ventilators and all. Just leave aside the accountability of it, but allocate kiya hai, just remember that. Looking at the figures, you know it is shamefully less. How do you expect the people to survive in that much? You know it's shamefully less. But कुछ तो किया है, सोचा नेक्स्ट टाइम जब अनाउंस करेंगे कुछ तो इंक्रीमेंट करेंगे इनके लिए, पैसे में इंक्रीमेंट, राशन में इंक्रीमेंट, उधर भी डाल दिए बड़े बड़े. देयर वाज नो अनाउंसमेंट ऑफ इंक्रीमेंट ऑफ मनी और इंक्रीमेंट ऑफ राशन फॉर दीज पीपल. जस्ट दैट दे हैव इंक्लूडेड द 10 crore people who were left out of this ration system now in the scheme, which I will talk about now. Now let's see with particularly the people who didn't have ration cards, who weren't covered under NFSA. Now what the government did was that they worked on 2011 census, which covered 80 crore people under NFSA. The population was 121 crores in 2011. But the increment could be around 92 crores now, checking the growth rate, which left around 10 crore people without ration cards. Okay, they were out of ration cards, but they still had enough stock to feed the rest 10 crore people also. Now, annual requirement for food grains is around 54 to 56 million tons for people under NFSA. India has 77 million tons of wheat and rice in reserves, even before the procurement of 2021 grains, which is more than a year's quota. It wasn't like we didn't have enough reserves of grains or anything like that. But still, people out of NFSA weren't given the ration because of our public distribution system. We sticking to our traditional methods, even after economists saying again and again that give it to people who come, who need it and who come and ask for it. Don't start bifurcating like that, because it's going to leave a lot of people hungry. People like Abhijit Banerjee said it. But 20 crore people with ration cards didn't get ration. What are we talking about people without ration cards? That to forget it. This raises so many questions on a public distribution system. There are some people who didn't get, but there are some people who got. And in that also, they didn't get enough what was allocated to them. They didn't get that much. There's corruption in the system. The ones who distribute that, they eat some of it. Not eat, matlab, literally. Kaat ke dete so that they can sell it elsewhere. But finally, Nirmala Sitharaman has realized that these 8 crore people, which is apparently 10 crore, have been hungry for 50 days. And finally, she has decided to give them food. Congratulations. Just hope she doesn't stick to that old system again and everyone gets what they want. Even if anyone comes, just give it to them. I just hope. Now let's get to the package. The matar ka samosa.
20 lakh crore rupiye ka hai.
First liquidity measure by RBI on 6 February, 2.8 lakh crores. Second liquidity measure by RBI on 27th March, 3.7 lakh crores. Targeted long-term repo operations on 17th April, 50,000 crores. Liquidity for mutual funds on 27th April, 50,000 crores. Which amounts to approximately 8 lakh crores out of 20 lakh crores. 8 lakh crores is liquidity measures. And then the actual relief came on 27th of March, which was 1.7 lakh crores for the relief of the poor. But isme bhi thoda sa jhol hai, which I will explain later on. So including all the liquidity measures and the relief package right now, our total came to around 9.75 lakh crores, which was already done in the past, which they have included in this package, the new package, which leaves us with 10.25 lakh crores. Out of that also, a little will be used in actual relief, which I will talk about later in the video. So let's get to liquidity measures first, which is worth 8 lakh crores. These are liquidity measures which are given to the banks to give loan to the people. So this isn't a relief, it's a loan. These are routine measures done by RBI when economy starts falling. So you decrease the rate of interest and give more money to banks so that they lend more money and businesses start to grow. So that in turn it boosts the economy. But there is no borrowing as of now, very less borrowing because of the present economic conditions of India. 5.47 lakh crores was given back to the RBI from the banks as on 13th May 2020, which shows that RBI's money lending hasn't worked out, which automatically brings the package to 14.53 lakh crores. Now, these are liquidity measures. They shouldn't be in the relief package in the first place because it is a loan. It is not a government spending. It will be spending only when a particular company defaults, doesn't pay back the loan. Then only it will be a cost, but that also not until the next year. Now, the first economic package which we had was 1.7 lakh crores. Now in this, there was this issue from 1.7 lakh PM Kisan Yojana worth 16,000 crores and 5,600 crores in NREGA scheme was already announced till 23rd March. So this was already announced even before this relief package. So they included it. Then there was excess food grains, billed at economic cost, and money given from construction workers welfare funds don't really belong to the union government. So the actual allocation was around 1 lakh crores rather than 1.7 lakh crores. And with the rest of the budget, they have done unrealistic calculations and then they have put it as relief in the economic package. For example, like reduction in TDS rates. So you'll be paying less tax, but it is not really a relief because that will just make a person hold the tax money for a longer time. But ultimately, they will have to pay their income tax in the end of the financial year. And they are counting it as relief when you have to ultimately pay it only. It's just giving you thoda sa in hand right now. Then reduction in rate of provident fund from 12% to 10%. Now, this is basically public's money. It's ultimately theirs. It is going to come back to them. But still, they have counted it under relief. In fact, the rate cut in provident fund is going to make things worse for the employees. Then again, in MSME loans, around 3 lakh crores has been allocated to give loans to micro, small, medium scale enterprises. So they will give these loans with no collaterals. Loans, liquidity, cash guarantees are important, definitely. But what is more important is that you give money in the hands of the poor and the people, which has been completely ignored in this package. When Nobel Prize winners like Abhijit Banerjee are going on saying again and again that give money in the hands of the poor and the people, this will help the poor in surviving basic needs. And when people have money in their hands, it will generate demand and that will kickstart the economy. Now people don't have money, so demand has fallen. Loans will get up businesses, but if there is no demand, what is the use of the loan? No one is going to buy the products. So mostly giving these loans, no one will pick the loans up because there is no demand. And even if they pick up, it might lead to bad loans, no repayment of the loans, and it will make a worse economic impact on India, which is already bad. Jayanti Ghosh, an economist, says that 7,000 per month for a period of 3 months and every individual with 10 kg of free food grains per month for a period of 6 months is likely to cost around 3% of our GDP, assuming 20% voluntary dropout. Every economist has a different solution, but one thing they have in common is that money should be given in the hands of the people, especially the poor. And not aisa chindi 500 rupaye nahi, zyada de do, food grain bhi zyada de do. Now there are estimates from actual money being spent as proper stimulus package. It varies from 40,000 crores to a maximum of 4.2 lakh crores out of the 20 lakh crores, which means that a maximum of 4.2 lakh crores can be spent on the poor, which is approximately 2.1% of the GDP. It is still the maximum amount which we have held. It might be lower too, but not higher. Hum kaha bol rahe ki hum sabko paisa do? Nahi bol rahe. Give it to the poor. They need the migrant workers. They are suffering so much. Nahi, kuch nahi karenge. Sirf naam ke liye 20 lakh crores ka package hai ye. Kuch kaam ka nahi hai. Kuch kaam ka nahi hai. Ye proper matar ka samosa tha. Proper matar ka samosa. Doubt hi nahi hai usme. और मोदी जी बीजेपी कितना झूठ बोलोगे, कितना झूठ बोलोगे हैं? लिमिट्स होती है यार. सो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल बिकॉज इसमें भी बहुत रिसर्च किया है. और नॉमिनेट मी फॉर नोबेल प्राइज प्लीज. थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर वॉचिंग द वीडियो. सी यू गाइज इन द नेक्स्ट वन.